Hello students, today we will study about the calculations based on chemical equations. Okay, a balanced chemical equation, it provides the quantitative details of reactants and products, the quantity of the reactants and products which are reacting or producing. In terms of it gives that quantitative detail in terms of the relative number of molecules or relative number of moles, relative masses and relative volumes if reactants and products they are in gaseous state. Now see how these things they provide us the information. Suppose there is an example where this is the reaction, 2H2 gas plus O2 gas, and we are getting 2H2O gas. Okay, see, if in terms of molecules we are talking, it means two molecules of hydrogen, they are reacting with a molecule, one molecule of oxygen to give two molecules of water. If we are talking in terms of moles, then two moles of this, one mole of this and two moles of this. If we are talking in terms of relative masses, then 4.032 AMU of this hydrogen. Actually, here they have taken mass 1.008. That's why it is 4.032 AMU. This is 32 AMU and this is 36.03 AMU. In terms of gram, if we'll write the same digits, and in place of atomic mass unit, we'll write gram. Now, the last one is the relative volumes. If the gases and if the reactants and the products are in the gaseous state, see. 44.8 liter of this, 44.8, 22.4 plus 22.4, 44.8 liter. This is one molecule only, so 22.4 liter. And here also two molecules means 44.8 liter at STP. So this is how we can write the reactants and products according to their quantity. Okay. Now there is a numerical related to this topic only. How much zinc should be treated with excess of dilute HCl? So we have to write the amount of zinc which should be treated to obtain 2.24 liters of hydrogen at STP. See, the reaction will be zinc. It is reacting with 2HCl aqueous to give ZnCl2 aqueous and hydrogen gas. 1 mole of zinc or 1 gram atom of zinc or 65.38 gram of zinc, it is producing 1 mole of hydrogen, or at STP it will be 22.4 liters at STP. So see here, 65.38 gram, it is producing 22.4 liters at STP. Since 22.4 liter of STP, hydrogen at STP, it is given by 65.38 gram of zinc. Therefore, 2.24 liters of hydrogen at STP will be given by 65.38 upon 22.4 into 2.24. It will be 6.54 gram. Now, limiting reagents. Now, we'll see what are limiting reagents. The name itself is telling that the limiting reagent, it is the reactant which gets completely consumed. Out of the combining reactants, the one which is completely consumed in the chemical reaction under consideration and whose amount limits the amount of the product. If it will be finished, then the reaction will stop. So its amount is limiting the amount of the product formed in the reaction. That is called a limiting reagent. Here I'll explain you an example. Suppose nitrogen and hydrogen, they were combining to form ammonia. Here 1 mole of nitrogen is required and 3 moles of hydrogen they are required. Suppose instead of 3 moles, we have been provided with 4 moles of hydrogen. Then only 3 moles will be consumed and 1 mole will be left, and nitrogen will be consumed completely. So here nitrogen is a limiting reagent because it was consumed completely and it was still left 1 mole. And if we'll take 2 moles of nitrogen and 3 moles of hydrogen, then 1 mole will be left here. It means the one or the amount of product formed in the reaction are decided by the substance which is consumed completely. If that substance will be consumed completely, the further reaction will be stopped. It will not matter the if the other substance is present in how much quantity. If one will be consumed completely, the reaction will stop. It means the reaction, the amount of product formed, it depends on that particular reactant which is present in the lesser amount or which will be consumed completely after the reaction. And such a substance, it is called limiting reagent. Now here is a numerical related to that. 1 gram of carbon are burnt in a closed vessel containing 1.5 gram of oxygen. See, carbon and oxygen, they are combining. 1 gram of carbon and 1.5 gram of oxygen, they are combining. Now we have to calculate which reactant is left in excess and find the mass of the excess reactant also and the mass of the product form. These three things we have to calculate. See, carbon burns in oxygen according to the following equation. C plus O2 gives CO2. 12.01 gram of C, 32 gram of oxygen. Here we will get 44.01 gram of CO2. Since 12.01 gram of carbon it required for combustion, how much? 32 gram of oxygen. Then this 1.0 gram of carbon will require oxygen equals to this 32 upon 12.01 into 1, that is 2.7 gram. It means for the complete combustion of 1 gram of carbon, we need 2.7 gram of oxygen. But oxygen which is provided to us, it is 1.5 gram only, which is 2 less from that which is required. It means oxygen will get completely consumed. It will get completely consumed. All the 1.5 gram will be consumed completely, because here we are needing 2.7 gram and we are there, we are having 1.5 gram only. So oxygen will be consumed completely and carbon will be left in excess. What will be left in excess? This carbon will be left in excess. Thus, what is the limiting reagent here? Oxygen. Because we were provided with 1.5 gram only and we were needing 2.7 gram. So oxygen is the limiting reagent. Now what else we have to calculate? See, since 32 gram of oxygen burned carbon, how much carbon? 12.01 gram. So 1.5 gram oxygen will burn carbon equals to this 12.01 upon 32 into 1.5. It means 0.56, only this much amount of carbon will be burnt when 1.5 gram oxygen which is provided to us, this is supplied. Then only 0.56 carbon will be burnt. And we were provided with how much of carbon? 1 gram of carbon we were provided with. See here in the question, 1 gram of carbon. We were having 1 gram of carbon, but because the amount of oxygen is less, that is 1.5 only. So only 0.56 gram of carbon will be burnt. So how much carbon will left unreacted? 1.0 into this one which is consumed. It is equal to 0.44 gram. It will left unreacted. Now, since 32 gram of oxygen is combined with carbon to give how much carbon excess? That is 44.01 gram. Therefore, if 1.5 gram will react, when 32 was reacting, it was giving 44.01 gram. And if only 1.5 gram which is provided to us, that will react, how much carbon dioxide will get? 44 upon 32 into 1.5, that is 2.1 gram only. So this is how we can calculate the amount of the substances formed or left and the limiting reagent also. Now the third type of calculations, they involve solution. Like commercially available concentrated HCl, if it contains 38% HCl by mass, 38% HCl by mass, then what is the molarity of this solution? If density it is given to us, that is 1.19 gram per centimeter cube. And what volume of the conch HCl is required to make 1 liter of 0.10 molar HCl? If we want to make 1 liter of 1.10 molar HCl, then how much of conch HCl in volume it is required? This we have to calculate. Okay, molarity and this. Now suppose we have 1000 centimeter cube of the given sample of HCl, okay, then density is equals to mass upon volume. Mass, if we have to calculate, it means density into volume. Volume is 1000, density is 1.19, so it means that 1190 gram of this it is present, or the mass of 1000 centimeter cube, it is equals to 1190 gram. Now the given sample, it contains 38% HCl by mass, it is given in the question. Hence the mass of HCl present in 1000 centimeter cube, mass of HCl present, it is equals to 1190 gram. So it will be equal to 38 upon 100 into 1190. It will come out to be 452.2 gram. Gram small w, volume we know 1000 centimeter cube. Mass will calculate of hydrogen, it is 1.008. Of chlorine, it is 35.45. The answer will be 36.46. Now the we'll put the formula. Molarity is equal to number of moles of solute upon volume into 1000. Now small w, it is 452.2 into 1000 upon molar mass, it is 36.46 into 1000. So the answer or the molarity, it will come out to be 12.40. The first part we have calculated, the molarity. Now the second part we have to calculate, like if we have to make 1 liter of 0.10 molar HCl, then how much of conch HCl will be required. And we know that it is 38% by mass. Okay. Then how much of this HCl will be required? The mass of pure HCl required to make 1 liter or 1000 centimeter cube of a solution of 0.10 molar HCl, it is given by small w, it is equals to 0.10 the molarity into 36.46 the molar mass of HCl into 1000 upon 1000. It means in grams it is 3.6. Okay. Since 38 gram of pure HCl, it was present in 100 gram of the sample, therefore 3.6 gram of pure HCl, this 3.6 gram of pure HCl will be present in the sample having mass. Mass of the sample will be 100 upon 38 into 3.6, that will be 9.5 gram. Now we will convert this 9.5 gram, it is in gram, we'll convert this mass into volume, because here in the question it is given that we have to calculate the volume of conch HCl. Okay. So volume is equals to mass upon density. We'll put the values here. Mass is 9.5, density is 1.19. it means 8 centimeter cube or 8 milliliter of HCl will be required to make 1 liter of 0.10 molar HCl. This is how we can calculate such numericals, and please practice more numericals from your book. And by tomorrow, we'll start with a new chapter, that is redox reaction. Thank you.